Yo, good morning, good morning. This is Anua Bucci. Out here, got my outfit on. Sometimes I put way more into my outfit than I do the actual workout. So, I'm in a town home and I am going to the gym. Yesterday I went walking, just went up one street, up the other, down another, and back into my townhome complex. But today, the weather's showing out, so I ain't going out. Walk straight to this gym. If I can get in. All right, made it in. Woo, oh, my stomach is hurting. Now, I find myself struggling between flesh and the spirit. I literally have someone that I don't want to be doing right to. I'm angry and upset about them. But then I will ask myself, how do I do better? How do I do what Jesus would do to myself? How would Jesus respond to me when I don't depend on him, come to him, abide in him, as his word says? His word says to abide in the Father, which is God. God still loves, God still comes to you, he still answers your prayers, he's still present in your life. And that's exactly what I should do. That's our answer. When there's people in your life that hurt you, offend you, and it's not in question whether it's a legitimate hurt, whether it should be something that we should take into account or consideration, the focus should really just be you and how you respond to that person, to that organization, to that place. And although I'm making a video, I really would like to build a community of people who are watching my video, who are hearing what I'm proclaiming, what I'm declaring over myself, what I'm asking of myself, what I'm asking of you, and let us hold each other accountable. Help us to understand, hey, it's not just what you said, but hey, I know what your goal is, and I see your behavior, and I see that your behavior is not gonna allow you to reach that goal. My goal is to operate in the spirit exclusively and to not continue to go back and forth based off of how I feel, how someone made me feel, how someone inspired my feelings by hurting my feelings. So if I could build a community of people that are watching my videos, interacting in the comments section and helping me to be called out by the behavior that does not align with operating in the spirit, speaking, thinking, behaving in the spirit, that is clearly illustrated through the scripture in Galatians chapter 5, when it says, well, what it looks like to operate in the flesh and what it looks like to operate in the spirit. So currently right now, I have always had our relationship with this person, and it's easier to just leave, right? And then, I saw something yesterday that said that some people aren't, believers in Christ aren't even marrying non-believers if God has anything to do with that, because God would rather that believer continue in the sanctification process and be a blessing to their spouse, who is the non-believer, and then neither one of them will perish. And so I, in this hard relationship, I definitely have enough evidence, enough reasons to leave. And when you look at it through a worldly perspective, I mean, when you just write down, well, they did this, they did that, recently they did this, and it was so intense, and it affected this person and place and thing, blah, 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 blah. But me spending time in the Word, it's like, yes. Like, I literally wanted to hear and see, I really wanted to read in the scripture, do they have my situation in there? Do they have what I'm struggling with in there? And if they do, I want to know how Paul was reacting, how David was reacting, how this prophet was responding, so that I can know exactly what to do. But we do know what to do. A lot of times, the unforgiveness that we have, or the pain that we have, really is unforgiveness. Because I'm not going to deal with unforgiveness if I already left that person, to my knowledge, actually, until I see them again, until I talk, until their name comes up again, then I'll realize, if I have the spirit within me, then I'll realize that I actually have bitterness or unforgiveness within me. But that's what's making my relationship so hard, because I'm not forgiving quickly. There's another offense that comes and causes me to be offended again, and I haven't forgiven for the last one. And so now I have a two-time offense that's on my mind, on my heart, and because of that, I am reacting based off of that. But if I can forgive immediately, forgive beforehand, stay in a forgiving state of mind, then I'll never be impacted by something that I know somebody doesn't have the capability to do. I'll never be feel depleted. I'll never feel saddened or sorrowed, because I already know who that person is submitting to. And they're submitting to themselves, to their fleshly desires. But I'm no different from them. If I'm submitting to my fleshly desires, my heart, and what's on my mind, and toward that person or toward anybody. So if I could just really focus on what God would think, which is so funny. It's such a, unfortunately, yeah, it was turned into a cliche. What would Jesus do? There were the bands, and it was actually a fad. It was a trend to have these bands that said, what would Jesus do? But I really need to draw on that. What would Jesus do in this situation? And it would be to the same thing that he advised. Is the same thing that he inculcated, that he practiced. And that's exactly what he's calling me and you to do, which is to forgive 7 times 70 in one day. Go ahead, count them. No one's committing that many things towards you in one day. And even if they are, Jesus is asking for you to continue to forgive them. And also in Romans is asking that we trust in him, in his word. God is saying that we want you. I'm shaking this camera, and it's irritating for me, so I can't imagine you watching this video. I'm walking on this treadmill. Oh, because I'm walking and talking. Because I was just like, I'm literally just walking on this treadmill, and then, but I'm having to catch my breath. I've been at this gym a long time. But I do know that what Jesus is asking us to do, so is not what I'm doing. So I'm not biting in the spirit. I am operating in the flesh. I am no different from a non-believer, because a believer does not just read the scripture, but they actually do it. And I'm not doing that. So that doesn't mean that I'm not a believer. It just means it's just a struggle area. It really, really is a struggle area. And I want to speak on that in the past tense. I want moving forward so badly, and I prayed about it yesterday morning and then the morning before. Please help me to just submit completely, finally, over to the Spirit in every way possible, in every expression that I could ever come forward toward anyone, or even myself. Help me to be forgiving. And what, I don't know what the opposite of just bitterness is, but I definitely store that up quickly. So I want to be forgiving, and then be able to give kindness. So Romans, I don't know where it is, where it just talks about how giving the if anyone wants to confront us as an enemy, that you should show them kindness, and that by doing this, vengeance is God, says the Lord. By doing this, you are putting coals upon the person's head. So whenever I don't show the person kindness, and I mean like immediately, whenever I don't show this person that wants to call themselves my enemy or wants to be my enemy, some people really just, they don't like you and they really want to be your enemy, whatever. or you want him to be, the pace should be immediately, and the response should be a loving kindness. And so if I could do that immediately, then I could really not so much stress about the upcoming offense, but I could focus on the loving kindness that they may be without, and like in their life, in their understanding, in their perspective, in their experience of life, they may be without that experience. So because I know of what Jesus did for us, I should give that to others. And I should trust that that same kind of love that he has already shown us is not finished. It is still outpouring toward me. So have faith in that. Have faith in the scripture that he says that just you show them, that my role is to show them loving kindness. My role is to show them loving kindness. My role is to show them loving kindness. And his role is vengeance. I'm going to end on that one. God's role is vengeance. Not, do not step in his way. Do not step in the way of his role so that he can, so that he can't take care of it with his almighty power. And you just with your little human self try to take care of something with somebody that'll actually put you in the same line. You actually, we put ourselves in punishment when we take care of it. We put ourselves in obedience when we say, God, I can't wait to see what you're going to do with this situation. That's trust. That's obedience. And that is literally what Yahweh is asking us to do. Signing off.